Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Gavinsky's Tutorials. Been a busy day, this is my second walkthrough today. So I'm going to make it a short one. I'm just going to do an overview of MFX Motto. So this just came out from ALM Busy Circuits, so same people who did Motto Acme, famous for their modular stuff. So what we got here is a Multi FX plugin. And I'm not going to do a full walkthrough, I'm just going to do a quick overview, look at each thing and see maybe a few key features and have a listen to them. It doesn't have any presets, weirdly, so you're going to have to do everything from scratch, just like on modular. I've had people not used to that. Some of these things are really cool. So $10, I think it's a pretty good deal. Definitely have a couple of different things in here. I don't know, by the way, if that's an intro price or what. So what we've got here, a bunch of different effects. Now, when you open it up, right, it will look like this. Right? It'll look like this. And then you can use the add button here to add things in. Okay. Tap here to view the controls for this one. Tap here to view the controls for this one. Tap here to get rid of that. Let's tap here and add it again. Oops, I didn't mean to add the same one, hang on. Okay, and then tap and drag to reorder things, right? Just grab that, drag it here. I see it's also got a copy button, I haven't used that yet. So let's go back to this one here. So I'm just looking at their list here. Okay, so quiet reverb, 90s rack style reverb with airy tails and era specific crunch. So I see here it has two options actually, 90s version and now. Got some features like a gating feature here and stuff as well. Double tap to reset. Knobs, by the way, drag horizontally for fast adjust. Sorry, drag vertically for fast adjustments, and drag horizontally for fine adjustments. Great. Okay, let's go to the next one. Almicon reverb, bright 80s digital reverb with modulation. Now it's not all reverbs in here, and there are a couple of really weird things. So brought the size up there. Diffusion. Okay. Damping. Wow, so that can get pretty experimental, this one. Bring that size down in diffusion a bit. Okay, so that's that one, Almicon. Next one, DigiPCM Echo. This is pretty cool. Listen to that. Early digital rack delay with multi-tap and modulation. Some of these things, by the way, it's a little bit weird. I think they need to work on the UI here. This must be a bug. Like this, when I tap here, the options are coming up here. That's really weird. I don't think it's supposed to be like that. So there's a 4-bit one. So I've taken all the dry out there. Let's just put that back in. Yeah, that must be a bug. Let's see, modulation. Ah, funky. Let's bring this down again. I like the sound of that. Okay, next one. So, I mean, I'm trying them one by one. Obviously, the idea is you can use more than one at a time, right? But I just want to let you hear what's going on. Tape tech echo. Tape style delay with wow, age, and lo-fi pitch shift. Pitch shift in this sounds great. Listen. And and I see here you can add in an extra couple of heads. Let me bring those heads off, take them off. Loop, pretty cool. Ping pong. Age. All right, nice. Wow. Yeah, so I love that shift and the loop feature and the extra heads. That's cool. Okay, next. A TY50 dynamics. So we got a couple of modes here. Tap it. When it's on the left, it's compression. Here, expander. So that's the expander. See, tilt. Okay, compression. So it has the sidechain feature. You're going to want to use multi-bus instances for that. And yeah, it is multi-bus. So you can use something else as your sidechain source. Multi-phaser. Bring this back up. So dry and wet amounts, depth and rate. So that's set up very hardcore. Let's bring that rate down a bit. It's got sync, number of stages. Nice. Infinite, up, down. Don't know what those are. Anybody know? Write in the comments, please. So yeah, I really don't think there is a manual actually for this app. I think there's just a manual for the modular. This panner, I haven't really heard this doing much. I mean, depth is up there. I've played around with rates and stuff. I never really hear any difference with this one. I don't know if it's broken or what, or if it's user error. Next one. This is really cool sounding. Metallic plate reverb with freeze and gate. So they're bringing the gate up. So, you know, we can bring that wet down if we don't want it so extreme. Size. Let's just hear that wet to see what it sounds like. I'll take the gate off. Let's see this tightness. All right. Bring the dry back in. Freeze. Reverse. This one sounds really great, I think. Okay, next, slinky reverb. This sounds brilliant. Listen to that. So, this length control is really fun to play with. Listen. Oh yeah, I love that. And we arguably haven't even got to the best one yet. So quite nice to play around with length and dampness at the same time. Really fun this. Love it. Chorus ensemble effect with, again, pitch shift. Super nice sounding. Listen to that. A number of voices, okay. Various options here. Some at least based on classic gear. Modulation, I guess. Okay, and then last, this is one of the really cool ones, I think. Bit corrupter. Let's leave it on post, I think. So, glitch looper simulating broken digital gear. So you're going to have to play around with the time to get something that sounds right. Let's put this glitch and repeat up. I bring down dry, so we've just got the wet. Let's hear that. 8-bit. See again this UI here, it's really weird. So let's try dry and wet and change the time. You hear this repeating? But yeah, it's definitely galloping horses here unless you play with the time setting. Actually, I like this one unsynced, I think. Seems a lot easier to get good results, yeah. So I guess it suits really small times. Yeah, I think I'd definitely keep that sync off for this one. This reverse sounds really cool. Huh. Oh, yeah. So, you know, stick that on, then bring this down here, put this after that. Or don't like that one, try the slinky reverb. That's the reverb before the corrupter. That's the reverb after. So, obviously you're going to have a lot of fun with this if you like weird stuff. Really cool. Okay, hope that was useful for you, everyone. Thank you. Take it easy and see you in the next video. Take care.